San Diego wildfires, Hurricane Gustav, the Kansas tornado. These are the natural disasters that send us to the shelter and send our next hero, Tad Agoglia, right into the storm. When tragedy strikes, Tad and his team are some of the first people on the scene to clear the roads, move trees that have crushed houses, and power up buildings. Tad gave up his home so that he could respond quickly. And so he travels the country in one of the best convoys ever created. 275-foot Mack trucks, a high-speed crane, a generator powerful enough to run a hospital, dirt bikes, satellite phones, hovercrafts, and a water pump. Now that's a hero who travels in style. He donates everything, his services, his time, and his equipment to those in need. He does this because, as he says, America deserves this type of response. He is the calm before, during, and after the storm. Tad is our hero.
When a disaster strikes a community, no matter how prepared you think you might be, there's chaos.
Power outage, they've got a full evacuation.
A significant tidal surge.
The damage just gets worse.
Please get out of harm's way.
I was a contractor for hurricane cleanup, coming in 1 to 2 months after the storm would hit.
When a huge tornado destroyed a whole community in Kansas, I decided to leave with some of my equipment
and find out for myself what was needed on day one after a storm hit.
There were buildings that needed to be powered up. There were flooded parts of communities that needed to be pumped out.
They didn't have the equipment they needed.
That's why I've made a decision to put my own personal finances and my business on the line to create the first response team. We're four guys with about $1 million worth of equipment responding to disasters all over the country for free. We watch weather patterns on the computer. We track a storm. We look at the size of it. We look at where it's going to hit. And it's a very simple decision.
I got my eyes in Indianapolis right now.
Our goal is to respond within the first few hours of the occurrence.
All right, let's roll.
This truck can disassemble a home in 15 minutes. This is what we use to open up roads.
This is a hovercraft. It's one of the best tools for water rescues in debris-filled water.
This is a specialized piece of equipment that can snake through 30 feet of a home to see if someone's underneath the rubble.
When you come up with all those resources, you really can make a huge impact.
He came from nowhere, you know, to help. He travels to places where nobody wants to be. You know, if he's got the resources available, he's on.
We're following disasters to hopefully save lives and to make a difference in communities.
I thank each and every one of them. And there's not, we will never, ever be able to repay them. Sorry.
America deserves this type of response.
Please join me in honoring CNN hero Tad Agoglia.
I came in from the wilderness, a creature void of form. Come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm.
The CNN Heroes Initiative reminds us in a time when hope seems difficult to come by, that if we just look around us, we can find reasons to be hopeful. Thank you to all those who have recognized the overwhelming needs of our neighbors that I've been working to address. I hope it brings others to champion the cause and that the first response team becomes a part of the long-term fabric of American resources. While spending time in disasters all over this country, I have been inspired by people who have experienced great loss. I have found that many of us long to live lives that exist beyond the material, leaving a legacy of hope in our wakes. May we all find the hero inside us by reaching out to others and in turn find that we are the ones being helped. Congratulations to all the heroes in this room tonight, and thank you to all the heroes of this world who have inspired each of us. Thank you.